Here we go. Special counsel John Durham indicting the principal source for the Steele dossier with 5 counts of lying to the FBI and creating a false narrative during the Trump-Russia investigation in 2017. If this sounds like big news, you're absolutely right. He's a Russian. Igor Danchenko appeared briefly in court yesterday, planning to plead not guilty before being released on bond. Joining us right now to react is former federal prosecutor and former U.S. attorney for Utah, Brett Tolman. Brett, what was key about this indictment, the third one for John Durham?
This indictment is the one that finally puts into place, components of this conspiracy that were only speculation. The fact that this is rooted deeply in two operatives that were coming together and trying to assist each other in coming up with a file that they could use to take down a candidate and then eventually a president was so deeply rooted in the Clinton campaign.
So this Russian, how does this Russian link back to the Clinton campaign?
Well, you have two individuals that were utilized in both Bill Clinton's campaign, and then you have Hillary Clinton and their campaign that are utilizing them. Payments being made through lawyers, the law firm of the campaign, to individuals. So what you now see are both sides of the conspiracy. You see where it came from, and you see those that were operating inside the conspiracy to fabricate out of whole cloth facts that they knew would be damaging to an up-and-coming candidate.
So Danchenko, who's not a flight risk, which is crazy because I absolutely believe he is linked to a longtime Clinton ad man, Dolan. How?
They're very much aware of each other, interacting in the Clinton circles, but it's more than that. They had to be closely connected in order to coordinate what they were feeding each other. And make no mistake, Danchenko was claiming that he had information about the collusion between Trump and Russia, and then he was utilizing Dolan as a potential source, and now Dolan is admitting that he is making up many of the aspects of the dossier. This is not the Steele dossier anymore. This is the Clinton dossier. And it's outrageous. And I'll tell you another thing, Brian. I don't think we're seeing the end. This is not the pinnacle prosecution of Durham. This is an individual you prosecute as early as you can and get into discussions about him exposing others in order to save his hide from federal prison.
Lies to FBI. And tell me if I'm wrong here. So Steele gets hired by Fusion GPS to do investigating, but he can't go to Russia. So we used Danchenko to give him information. That helps formulate the dossier. It turns out Danchenko says, what I put in there was just all hearsay. I don't know if any of it's corroborated, but he lied about that. Who's Danchenko? He's linked to Chuck Dolan Jr., longtime PR executive with Bill and Hillary Clinton, and is known as one of these great Democrats. Why would they do something like this? Initially, it seems, because of her email scandal. All the focus on her email and the terrible decision she made as Secretary of State, crushing any type of forensic evidence by destroying her server. And now all of a sudden, let's put the heat on Donald Trump. Let's make up stories about Russian banks linked with Donald Trump. We'll come up with this dossier. We'll hire Steele. And then we'll let Steele cycle this story through the back channels of the New American press and Democratic lawmakers. So all of a sudden, you got this counter narrative. And Donald Trump is sitting there saying, what are you talking about? And then when he goes crazy because the Secretary of State allows this probe to go, Attorney General allows this probe to go through.
They use the media, they use the FBI, who knew that it was unreliable, and they created the very thing that they were manipulating to suggest to the American people, and they did this to try to protect Clinton as well as try to promote her. It's outrageous, and additional individuals need to be prosecuted, and people need to be fired from jobs in both the FBI and otherwise.
And the networks didn't cover it, no cable or broadcast, because it goes right back to their loved one, Hillary Clinton. That's we're heading the next step. We'll see who breaks first.